By the end of this video, you will learn what is a design system and how to use a design system to build this. The formal definition of a design system is a collection of reusable components, patterns, and guidelines that helps designers and developers build consistent and cohesive products. But you can just think of it as a lot of templates for designers. So if you need a button, just go find a button in the design system, copy it, paste it in your file, change the text. A design system component will specify the spacing, the color, the font, everything you need, so you don't have to worry about the nitty-gritty detail when you are doing your project. Usually, there's a dedicated team building the design system. Your job is to learn how to use those design systems to design for your team's project. And let's just dive right into it. Please go to Figma community and search for the End Design design system. The title is End Design Open Source, and the thumbnail shall look like this. Please click into it and then click Open in Figma. As a designer who works in a large tech company, this is a design system that is similar to what I use every day. On the left side, you can see that there are so many pages in this design system and it could feel overwhelming. But here's a secret. You only need to know one page to use the design system. Just go to the second page called Components Overview, and this is like a huge menu of things. Every card here is clickable. If you need anything, come here, look for it, click on it, and it will take you to the page that documents that component. Now we are on the button component page. On the left side of this page, it has all the documentation that tells you how to use this component and when to use this component. And on the right side of this page, right after components, it has the component that you can copy and paste to your design file. If you need to find another component, just go back to the Components Overview page on the left, and then you can choose any other component to look into. Again, it will directly take you to the page of this specific component, and on the left, there's the documentation, and on the right, there's the component you can copy. In a tech company, it is unlikely that you will start a project from an empty file. That is why I also want to introduce you to this third page called Templates and Pages. Usually, for the main pages of your tech product, they will have a template for you ready in the design system. However, it is also likely that you will just simply copy some of your colleagues' work as the starting point of your new project, because your work could be just add a feature to this existing product. Starting now, I will take you through how to use this End Design system to build this exact e-commerce page for sellers, and this is a listing page. First, let's add a page to this file and then call it Design System Practice. Keep in mind that when you are actually working with a tech company, never add another page in the design system just for your own project. You shall always start your own project in a different file. This is more for the practice purpose, so I put it here. Let us start from the Templates and Pages page and then find a page that's the most similar to what we want to create. Let's choose the search table on the bottom right and then copy that to our page. You can see that many elements in this page is different from the page we want to create. The tip is to be patient and focus on one section at a time. Let's start from the header. I'm going to create a rectangle just to highlight where I'm focusing on. You can do the same. Add a stroke and then minus the fill so it won't block our content. Now pause the video and try to adjust the header part to this design. Here's how I did it. First, zoom in and then click into the text to change the text. Then click into the logo. Now, keep in mind that there are multiple layers, so you might need to click multiple times in order to select the right thing. And then hit delete. When you are working from a design system component, deleting an element doesn't really delete it, it just hides it. So you can always turn it back on. And on the left side, you can see that there's an eye icon and you can turn on the eye and turn off the eye. So what is the point of using a design system? Here, let me demonstrate. If you select this element and then right click and then hit go to main component, you can see that there is a main component built in the design system. And then if you change the main component in the design system, usually it will be the design system team making this change. For example, if one day your entire design team decides to change the font of your entire product to SF Pro,
Then, if you go back to your design, you don't have to change anything in your file, and everything in your element will already be changed into this new font SF Pro, simply because this is tied to the main component in the design system. I will hit Command Z multiple times and let's keep going. For the right side of the header, click into the text to change the text. Click multiple times on the profile icon and then hit Fill, and then click Choose Image to replace the image with your personal profile picture. To turn this from a square into a circle, just select it again and then go to the top right and then turn corner radius to its maximum. We are now done with the header. Now let's work on the cider. Now pause the video and try to adjust the cider to this design. Here's how I did it. First, delete all the icons by clicking into these elements. Again, because there's multiple layers in each component, that is why you need to click multiple times to select the icon. Once this is done, replace all the content with the new text. And we don't really need the last row, so you can simply delete the entire last row. Please also don't forget to replace the content for these secondary pages. Now you may notice that the unsold page is selected, but we want the active page to be selected. This is where variants come in. Select the active component and then go on the right side, toggle on selected, and you can see that this component becomes the selected component. There are actually three properties you can play with here. So for the unsold, just turn off the selected property, and here we have the cider. If you're curious about how this component is set up with multiple variants, just select one element, right-click, and then select Go to Main Component. This dash box includes all the variants and properties this component has. Now that we're done with the cider, let's work on the breadcrumb. The breadcrumb is the top component on the right side. So pause this video again and see if you can build this breadcrumb. Here's how I did it. First, update the content for the first two texts. Then delete the rest of the elements. Then let's select active, and then go to the right, and then turn current on. Current is a property that this design system component has, and it's not like every single Figma file will have this property named current. It's all based on how this component is built in the design system. So different component in different design system will have different properties under different names, but you can always turn things on and off to check what these properties are. And now let's also rename the header to active listings. And then you're done with this part. Only two parts left. For this part, please pause the video and try to see if you can build this search bar. I will give you a hint. You will have to delete your current component and then find the search bar element in the design system and then paste it to here. Here's how I did it. First, I select the component that we have in the template and I deleted that, because this element is not really a traditional search bar. So in order to find the search bar element, let's go to the components overview page and let's click the card that's named under input. And then the search bar is on the top right of this search box. So let's copy this one by hitting Command C or Control C. Then let's go back to our page and then try to paste this element on our page. Here, you might encounter some difficulties. It is difficult to place it exactly where you want it to be. This is because design system templates usually utilize a lot of layers of auto layout. I have a dedicated video on auto layout on the top right if you want to check it out. But here, the solution is that you have to select the right frame. You need to use some trial and error, and the right frame here is named under content. Once you selected content, just hit Command V or Control V to paste the element. It will go directly below the table because there's already auto layout set up in this frame. So in order to move it up, just use your keyboard to hit the up button and then it will move it on top of the table. To change its length, just select the element and you can drag the edge to the right or to the left. Now, how can you decide how long you want this element to be, right? In a tech company, you usually don't make this decision just based on how it looks. Instead, you can use a column grid. So select the larger element that this component belongs to. In this case, it is this large right side box that's named under page container. You can see that there's a column icon. and right beside it, there's an eye icon. Click the eye icon. It will automatically turn on the column grid. And then you can see the guideline for horizontal alignment. So I'll reselect the search bar and then drag it until its length is lined up with the grid. Now, grids are often used for horizontal alignment, but not vertical alignment. Use the grid whenever you find horizontal alignment difficult to make, but don't let the grid constrain your design. It is okay to not follow the grid sometimes. Now we are off to the final, most difficult part, which is the table. So pause the video and see if you can figure out how to turn your table to this. Here's how I did it. Changing the text shouldn't be that difficult, but each row is repeated for several times, and I don't want to change the text every time. So I'm going to delete the rest of the rows and focus on making the first one perfect. You will have to click multiple times to select the right component, and you will have to hold Shift to multi-select. And here, as soon as you delete all the rest of the rows, you can see that the column width has changed. This is again because of the auto layout of this design system component. And it also thinks that this width is impossible to edit. This is because there's a limitation in the design system component, and this happens all the time. In this case, right click and then select Detach Instance. You should be able to adjust the width now. Detaching an instance means that you are detaching it from the design system element that it used, which means you are detaching from all the setups of this element. That is why it is more editable. But the cons to this is that whenever the design system component changes, it will no longer reflect on this new element. For the second column, you might encounter the difficulty of replacing this text with an image. So here's how I did it. Go to the Components Overview page, and then let's find Image. Once you are here, copy this element and then paste it in our practice page. You can see that it is difficult to put this exactly where we want it to be. This is because this element is also not detached yet. So let's select this element and then right click and then Detach Instance. Here I use the shortcut Command Option B. Now, if you select Table Cell Text, you shall be able to paste the image directly into this element, and you shall also be able to delete the text. And you shall also be able to adjust the width of this entire element. To be more precise, you can go to the right and then choose Hug Content. You should be able to adjust the rest of the first row by the same method. Detaching instances many times, and then replacing the content many times, and also clicking just to select the right component, and of course, adjusting the width and height because things are constantly changing because of your editing. When you are doing a project on your own in a tech company, try not to detach instance if you can make the adjustment without detaching the instance. But if you feel like this element is not changeable, it does not fit your need, then definitely detach the instance or work with the design system team to create a new component so that it meets your team's need. And as a recall, if you want to select multiple rows just to delete the rest of the rows, you need to hold Shift on your keyboard. And as soon as you finish polishing up the first row, you shall be able to easily copy the first row to form the next few rows. However, you have to do it one by one just because of the order that these different elements are grouped. And once you finish this, please also delete the right side of the top element. And in order to left align search table, you will have to select Table Toolbar, and then on the right side, play with the auto layout. So change space between to pack. If you don't understand what this means, check out my auto layout tutorial on the top right. And finally, change the content, and you've completely finished this tutorial. Wow, I am so proud of you.
You just learned how to use a design system. And do you know what this page actually came from? Is actually the active listing page from eBay Seller Hub, where eBay sellers manage their listings. And you can see the huge difference between using the eBay design system versus the end design system, right? So even for the same set of design, by using a different set of design system, the style, the realization, and the feeling of the product will completely change. I suggest you to take a screenshot of another app or website that you like and try to recreate that page by using this end design system. You'll find it very entertaining, very fun, and also just surprising to see the final result. Now, I also want to tell you that I'm developing a Figma course. So please check out the link in the description to help me fill out the questionnaire, and you will get early access, also discount, whenever this Figma course gets released. This Figma course will be designed for people like you who want to learn more in depth about Figma, but in a fun and very concise way. And don't forget to also check out my other Figma tutorial videos here. I'm Aliena. I will see you in this video. Bye.